Now what's he all excited about? I guess maybe it's that Powder Monday morning. Gonna love a Powder Monday with nobody there. Jay Peak Resort will be interdispersing that video from Josh Worth of the Montgomery Lodge in Vermont. I could not make it up north. I do resent that. I'm in the south where there's still just a huge amount of snow. Not quite enough to ski the cliff. Very windy and cold outside. Here's an image from Sugarloaf. The wind chasing you down the mountain. Winter has returned after a brief thaw. This weekend, we host the fourth stop of the Ski the East free ride tour. It's Side Country, top of Sugarloaf. It is going to be a windy one on Saturday, and it's going to be snowing. There's quite the weather event happening now. There's an almost tropical system coming out of the Gulf of Mexico. There's another front coming from Hudson Bay, and they're both aimed at the northeast. It looks like New York and New England are going to be snowing a lot of the weekend. Ontario, Quebec included, perhaps the Canadian Maritimes, not so much Pennsylvania South, could actually rain Massachusetts, Connecticut, and Rhode Island a little bit on Saturday before changing to snow on Sunday. But the mountains from southern Quebec, northern New York, here in Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine, and perhaps parts of the Maritimes, are looking at a 1 to 2 foot snowfall. Initially, it's going to be a strong northeast wind on Saturday, so up in the snowfields at Sugarloaf, it could be kind of hairy, actually. And then on Saturday night, the rain snow line is going to collapse south towards Wauwatchuset, where it may snow most of the day on Sunday. And the forecast accumulation map shows a big double digit very close to Mount Washington. And this is it's a rough estimate, of course. It'll all be changing, but it does look like a double-digit snowfall lasting for most of the weekend. The weather pattern is extreme. Did you hear about what happened in Italy at Caracotta? About 100 inches of snow in 24 hours. Ski the snow piles. That's what we're doing just about anywhere. And on the other side of the world, there are these super cyclones near Australia. Pam may go to 150 miles an hour. So the atmosphere is all churned up all around the globe. Last year, on March 17th, we had one of the coldest St. Patrick's Days you can ever have, and we're going to do it again this year. So after the snow stops this weekend, we're going to have a Monday off, and then another Arctic front on Tuesday. It'll probably be Monday night, Tuesday. More powder for Tuesday, but then it's really going to be cold and windy midweek, and then after that, we kind of let it up a little bit. Yeah, we're still wondering, is the vortex ever leaving? Is the snow ever going to melt? It has not rained in the northern mountains of New York through northern Maine now since the middle of June, going on 8 weeks. And although there was a thaw and things got kind of fast, it has not rained. And now we have more snow in the forecast and uninterrupted cold and snow to finish out March in the Northeast. So we're gonna be yee-haw-ing all the way into April. See you on the slopes. Woo!